StellarIdeas.com, painting with a purpose. This is part of a series of videos of the plein air painting exhibition called Hope, From Robe to Riches. This exhibition tells the story of the journey of Mei Ling, a 19-year-old Chinese woman who travelled from southern China to the goldfields of Victoria in Australia in 1857, near the border. Mei Ling could hardly breathe. She was trapped in a barrel and her shoulder hurt. She and others had heard of bushrangers and corrupt officials seeking to extract the £10 landed tax at the border. So they paid a bullocky to take them over, hidden in barrels. The barrel was crushingly cramped. It must have fallen off the dray. She could not remember. She'd been unconscious for some time. She heard muffled sounds around her, like others crying out. She tried to yell. Her voice was too weak and her throat hurt. She fell unconscious again. Next, she woke up in a room with a Western woman cooling her forehead. Later, the boy in the bed next to her whispered that they were on a homestead near Edenhope. The bullock had dumped them in the bush. She and the boy were the only survivors. The others had suffocated. The boy's name was Ping, and he was 14 years old. There were many Chinese safely living on this property, and Ping had news of her brother. Shung may be with a large group on the other side of the Grampians. A massive strike had been found by their fellow miners who were now calling for all Cantonese to gather there to protect the claim. Hundreds were headed for the Canton Lead, as it was becoming known. Mei Ling's collarbone was fractured, but she was desperate to reach Shung. The homestead family healed her wounds and packed some food and clothes for her journey. They lent her and Ping a donkey to carry their belongings. Luke Best, the settler's youngest son, offered to guide them as far as the Chinese commune in Sanford. But even with Luke's help, they still had to cross very treacherous land, most of it owned by settlers with guns, who were not tolerant of strangers and really did not want people trekking through their properties.